Hi everyone, welcome to CRSK Tech YouTube channel. This is Rajkumar. Today we are going to look at some basic questions from Java which will be more helpful for beginners. Let's start now. Question number one, what is source code? Human understandable code written in high level programming language is called a source code. C language, C++ language, Java language, these all are high level programming language. The program written in high level programming language is called a source code. For example, C program or C++ program or Java program, which is called a source code. Question number two, what is machine code, or we can say native code or binary code? Machine understandable code written in low level programming language is called as machine code. Machine language is a low level programming language. The program written in machine language, which is called as machine code. 01 is a machine code. We cannot understand the machine code. Machine can only understand the machine code. Question number three, what is bytecode? A JVM understandable code generated by Java compiler is called as bytecode. Bytecode is also called as magic value. We cannot understand the bytecode, even machine cannot understand the bytecode. JVM can only understand the bytecode. If you want to see the bytecode, you just write one small Java program, then you compile it using Java compiler. So Java compiler, it will convert the source code into bytecode, then it will store it in one .class file. You just open the .class file, you can see the bytecode. Question number four, why C and C++ are platform dependent and why Java is a platform independent? For these two questions, I have given clear explanation in my previous video. If you didn't watch it, please go and watch my previous video so you will get clear information why C and C++ are platform dependent and why Java is a platform independent. I will also explain in this video why C and C++ are platform dependent. So when you compile C program or C++ program on one operating system, then a C compiler or C++ compiler, it will generate that operating system understandable machine code. So the machine code generated on one operating system, we cannot run it on any another operating system. For example, I have written one C++ program on Windows operating system. Now I will compile it using a C++ compiler on Windows operating system. Now the C++ compiler, it will convert source code into machine code on Windows operating system. So now the machine code generated on Windows operating system, I cannot run it on any another operating system. That's why C and C++ are platform dependent. Question number five, why Java is a platform independent? So when you compile Java program on one operating system, then Java compiler will generate the bytecode. So bytecode is a common for all operating system. You can run the bytecode on any operating system which has JVM. JVM will understand the bytecode, then it will convert to machine code. So JVM can only understand the bytecode. So JVM, it will read the bytecode, then it will convert to machine code of particular OS. Because of this bytecode and JVM, Java is a platform independent. Because of platform independent, you can write Java program once and you can run it on anywhere. We can say write once, run anywhere. Question number six. I have written one program in C or C++ and another program in Java. So which program will be executed fastly and why? The answer is C or C++ program execution is faster than Java program because C program or C++ program, when you compile using C compiler or C++ compiler, it will directly convert the source code into machine code. So you can execute machine code directly on machine. But the Java compiler, it will convert the source code into bytecode first, then it will Java interpreter, it will convert a bytecode into machine code. So there is a two process. That's why C or C++ program execution is faster than Java program. Question number seven, what is Java compiler? Java compiler is a program developed in C or C++ programming language with the name Java C. So Java compiler is responsible for following task. So Java compiler will check syntactical error and grammatical error of the Java program. If there is no syntactical error and grammatical error, then Java compiler will convert the source code into bytecode. Question number eight, what is Java interpreter? So Java interpreter is a program developed in C or C++ programming language with the name Java. So Java interpreter is responsible to convert bytecode into machine code line by line. Then it will execute the machine code on machine. Because of converting and executing line by line, Java program execution was slower in initial version of Java. Question number 9. What is JIT compiler? So JIT stands for JIT stands for just in time. So just in time is a compiler, or we can say is a component of Java runtime environment. So JIT compiler compiles or translate the necessary part of bytecode into machine code instead of converting line by line. For example, Java interpreter, it will convert a line in your dot class file or your program. There is a block, for example, if block, for block is there, for looping statement, if block, these all are block. So if there is any single statement, for example, system.out.println is a single line statement. Wherever single line statement will come, Java interpreter will convert those line, those single statement. And wherever block is come, JIT compiler will convert those block from bytecode into machine code. So because of JIT compiler, Java program has, because of that JIT compiler, the performance of Java program has improved. So JIT compiler, it will always convert bytecode into machine code. So wherever the block is there, wherever for block, if block is there, JIT compiler, it will convert those block from bytecode into machine code. Wherever single line is there, interpreter, it will convert those single line from bytecode into machine code. What is JDK or SDK? So both are same. JDK stands for Java Development Kit. SDK stands for Java, Software Development Kit. So JDK is a Java software, or we can say it's a set of various utility programs which are required for developing Java application and executing Java application. Without JDK, we cannot develop Java application and we cannot execute the Java application. So JDK is a Java software, or we can say set of various utility programs which are required to develop Java application and execute the Java application. JDK is a platform dependent because we have separate JDK for separate OS. We have different OS, right? Windows, Linux, Mac OS. For each OS, we have different type of JDK. For Windows OS, we have separate JDK. For Linux OS, we have separate JDK. For Mac OS, we have separate JDK. So there are various JDK provided for various operating system. So the following are various utility programs provided under JDK. So when you install JDK, so along with the JDK, JRE will be installed. JDK is a Java software, or we can say a set of various utility programs which is required for developing and executing our Java programs. Without JDK, we cannot develop Java application, and without JRE, we cannot run the Java application. So we have various utility programs under JDK, which are Java development tools and source files, JRE, etc. So Java development tools, or we can say Java tools or Java components, which are Java C. Java C is a Java compiler, Java is a Java interpreter, Java P is a Java profile, char. So we can create a char file. These all are tools which is available after install JDK. Question number 11. What is JRE? JRE stands for Java Runtime Environment. So it is an implementation of JVM. So JRE is an implementation of JVM. So JRE contains class libraries, interpreter, JIT compiler, etc. So only JRE is enough to run Java programs. Without JRE, we cannot run our Java program because JRE will provide complete environment to run our Java application. For example, in a program, we have a class and we have object and we have class level variables and we have method level variables. For all memory space is required. So who will provide memory space? So JRE will provide memory space. So JRE will provide complete environment to run our Java application. So without JRE, we cannot run our Java application. Question number 12, what is JVM? So JVM stands for Java Virtual Machine. So it is a specification provided by Sun Microsystem. So JVM implementation provides an environment to run our Java application. So JVM, JRE, so the JVM is part of JRE, or we can say JVM is an instance of JRE at runtime. So Sun's implementation of Java virtual machine itself is called as JRE. So JVM, we are telling the JRE will provide the complete environment to run our Java application. So once you install JRE, the JVM will be available. So JVM is a part of JRE, or we can say JVM is an instance of JRE at runtime. So Sun JRE is available as part of JDK, and also we have separate JRE application. There are many vendors has implemented JVM. Some of them are Sun JRE, IPM JRE, Oracle JRE. There are different vendor is available. They are providing different JRE, so which has JVM. So thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our YouTube channel CRSK Tech Java, and please click on bell button on right side to get more updates. Thank you so much for watching our video.